So this week I'll show you another plastic fantastic camera, the Konica Big Mini BM302. Unlike 35mm autofocus SLRs, point and shoots have gotten really expensive in the last couple of years. Kendall Jenner went on The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon and showed him her Contax T2, and I'm not sure if prices were already going up, but definitely after she went on the show, prices went through the roof. I think the T2 is about $800 on eBay, and the T3 can be like $1,300 up to $1,800 for the silver one and $2,200 for the black one. The other high-end point-and-shoots, like the Minolta TC1 and Ricoh GR1, those are, you know, in the 800s up to the 1200s or something like that. And even the lower-end, semi-premium Yashica T4 is, you know, $400. So it's just way too expensive, I would say. The Konicas are, like, a fairly good deal. Relatively, you can get these for like $150, $160 or so. But even then, it's pretty expensive. I don't exactly recommend getting any of the nicer point-and-shoots anymore just because they're so expensive. And especially because they're totally computerized and you're going to need backups for parts because they're just gonna break on you. The first one of these I got, I took 7 photos with it, and then the autofocus motor died, even though it looked completely brand new. I guess the parts are just getting old and they're starting to fail. You can get them repaired to a certain extent. PPP repairs will do, you know, the simpler things like fixing the flash or fixing the motor wind or maybe the extension of the lens, but other things involving the CPU or the AF motor or even the LCD panels, you can't really fix that stuff unless you have parts for them. And even the parts bodies these days for point-and-shoots are getting really expensive. So I would recommend getting a cheaper point-and-shoot just so you can get parts bodies. Definitely recommend that you get backups these days. Don't spend $1,000 or $2,000 on a point-and-shoot. It's insane, but whatever, it's your money, okay? There's not a whole lot to say about, you know, the handling and feel of this camera. It's pretty small and compact. You can put it in a chest shirt pocket, or if you have looser fitting jeans or chinos, you can put it into one of those pockets too. There's no grip, but you know, it's so small and light, you don't really need a finger grip or anything like that. Even though the outer casing is plastic and sort of, you know, kind of, makes noise when you squish it, it's, you know, it's pretty durable, I think. I think the Konica Big Minis look really nice, even compared to the Porsche-designed Contaxes. Let's see, so you turn it on with the on button up here. People say the Big Minis are kind of loud, but it doesn't really sound all that loud to me. That's what it sounds like. the button's kind of squishy. It's not really clicky or anything like that. But it's doesn't feel cheap exactly. It doesn't really wiggle around or anything like that. And the shutter button feels squishy. And if it can't autofocus, it has a red light there. But if it can focus, then there's just this green light. And the shutter is pretty quiet. Let's see. Okay, there we go. So you can hear how loud the motor wind is, but you know, in most situations, outdoors, or you know, indoors at some sort of party, or you're eating out with your friends, the motor wind is not going to bother people. If you're in church or something, or some other situation where you need to be quiet, I don't know, should you even be taking photos in a really sensitive situation? I don't know. But anyhow, the motor and the autofocus sounds, it's not that bad as far as the Big Mini is concerned, I don't think. And aside from that, you have a little switch to open the back. And the viewfinder, it's pretty typical point and shoot viewfinder. Kind of small, not the brightest. The frame lines don't move when you focus closer or anything like that on a like you would find on a nice rangefinder. But you know, none of the viewfinders on these point and shoots, or even the high-end point and shoot like Contax, they're just not very good. They're totally decent. They get the job done. On the back here, you have really, really tiny buttons to change the modes. And the larger pill-shaped ones, those are like decent to change. But these little tiny round ones, like these, and then this one, you need this little nubbin on the strap to be able to push those in like that. If you don't have the strap, then you should probably take a toothpick with you wherever you go. So that's really all there is. I guess I could show you the battery door. It's like that, I guess. No spring in there. And oh, when you open the back, you have to make sure not to pull this back like very roughly or anything, because there's a cable, a ribbon cable in there that communicates to the LCD displays on the back. That's pretty much it, really. It's a nice camera with a really great lens. I like that it doesn't have any leaf blades to cover the lens, and it just has a UV filter on it. It's more durable, I think. The flash, actually, Konica's always good with flashes. The flash is pretty strong and usable. You can use it for all the usual sort of party photos. And what else is there on this thing? The tripod's on the corner. And that's pretty much it. So I picked this one because it was relatively affordable, and also because it's the camera that Hiromix uses. She's one of the the girl photographers that became well-known in the 90s in Japan. And her photography is sort of predates Instagram, of course, and a lot of the subject matter and themes are the same, so you'll get your photos of like people hanging out at parties, dressing up in fun outfits, and she also has photos of cats. And let's see, what else is there? Where are the food photos? I like the food photos because that's just so typical to put up on Instagram nowadays. So, and more food photos. So, you know, and also some sort of just nice things she sees. So I really like the snapshot aesthetic, and Hitomix is different than most other books that have been published, because things like let's see here. Okay, other classic snapshot photo books like Mangold's Ballad of Sexual Dependency and Richard Billingham's Raise a Laugh. These books are a lot, you know, sort of grimmer and darker, but her book, it's more fun, and more lighthearted. There's a sense of, you know, like freedom and youthful freedom, I guess, and just sort of joie de vivre, people enjoying life instead of being totally depressed. That's pretty much it for the contacts for the Konica Big Mini. If you have any questions, just let me know in the comments, and I'll see you next week. Thanks for watching. Hope you have a good week. Bye.